Well, a Brisbane primary school has achieved what many others around the country have been unable to do during the pandemic, recording zero transmissions within the school community.
Wowzers. And it's all thanks to a group of science-loving dads who are determined to protect their kids and also school staff. Take a look.
When the Queensland border fell and a new COVID variant began to emerge...
Tonight, Omicron is exploding across Queensland.
An emergency National Cabinet meeting will today respond to the growing crisis over Omicron.
Our best chance is herd immunity. That's the dire warning delivered tonight by the state's top doctor.
One school nestled in Brisbane's west was fearing the worst.
We were really nervous about having to replace teachers, about the prospect of collapsing classrooms, and about our students and our staff getting sick.
And their fears quickly became reality as an Omicron wave ripped through southeast Queensland schools.
It's not something to be taken lightly. We really need to protect the children, but also the staff.
And so Brisbane Independent School began working to ensure it didn't fall victim to an outbreak by engaging with parents who also had concerns.
I have kids that are 6 and 8 years old in the school, and I have friends and family overseas who are further ahead of us in their pandemic experience. So for a variety of reasons, I wanted to be proactive about ensuring a low transmission environment for my own kids.
Jay, who's also an emergency room doctor in central Queensland, approached his colleagues overseas and scientists to work out how to prevent an outbreak in the school. He quickly realised other dads at the school had expertise in similar fields, so they teamed up and figured out the air in classrooms needed to be clean.
When you and I breathe, we're breathing in oxygen and we're breathing out carbon dioxide. And so the air that we breathe out has carbon dioxide in it. It also might have COVID in it if we have COVID and we don't even know it.
So to measure that dirty air, they installed these small square monitors in every classroom to gauge carbon dioxide levels.
So the best thing you can do is to work with your ventilation to get new air in and dirty air out.
And once they noticed the high levels of dirty air, they brought in these guys, HEPA filters or air purifiers, a large box-like machine which filters tiny particles in the air to make it clean. But figuring out how many the school needed and where they should be placed was pretty tricky to solve. So an old school smoke machine you'd see at a kid's disco was brought in.
See where the smoke moved, see where it settled. You know, if you're getting smoke kind of catching in an area, well then that's an area now where you should put a HEPA filter.
And the results, well, speak for themselves. Not one outbreak has been recorded in the school, zero transmission since the pandemic began.
To stand here today and say that there's been no on-site outbreak at school is incredible.
And according to the kids, the air purifiers are great.
Why do you think they're great, Finn?
Well, because all of the carbon dioxide and all of the people that are breathing out, that connects to here.
What do you think about the school trying to protect you from COVID-19? That's pretty cool, isn't it?
Yeah. We got the school guinea pigs in the first lockdown, and that was really fun.
Now you've got these. What's better, this or a guinea pig?
Now the school's achieved the incredible. Both Jay and Lockie want every school around the country to know it can be done.
There's absolutely a cost involved. Total outlay at the moment is about $25,000. But again, what's the potential consequences of this? Is that you've got massive amounts of students and teachers away, you're putting supply teachers in. That's a massive cost.
So if we're proactive, we can get ahead of all of the issues that are going to slow us down for years to come. You got me feeling